Hey everybody, it's Pastor David from Walden Community Church. Hey, it's Monday, and every Monday we have a devotional. We have a time where we can start off our week together, both with a little scripture, something to think about, a prayer, because on Mondays we used to have a prayer group that met in the morning for coffee, and we would read over the different prayer requests, talk about some of the things that were going on in our own life, and then find a way to not only pray for each other, but pray for other members of the church. And so we want to continue that time together. And so we just do this little devotional here on YouTube. Of course, we do have our prayer email that goes out. There is a prayer chain, and we use that to communicate some of the needs that are in our church. And so if you're not getting those or you want those, you can send an email to the office, to Kim or Valerie, and they can stick you on the prayer list. That's office@waldenchurch.com. Just send us an email and we'll add you to that prayer list. So today, this morning, I was thinking about the Lord's Prayer, thinking about how the disciples went to Jesus and they asked him, "Master, teach us to pray." Probably because they saw him pray or heard him pray. And you know how sometimes you can listen to somebody else pray and you think to your head, in your head, "Wow, they're a really good, they pray really well. Like, I wish I could pray that well." Or, "I wish I had the courage to pray in front of people or to pray that eloquently. They're not tripping over their words. They're saying the things that I want to say, or they're saying the things that I feel." And so they go to their teacher, right? They go to their rabbi and they say, "Rabbi, teach us. Teach us to pray like you." And so we have the Lord's Prayer, and that's one of the reasons why we say it. I don't know that Jesus wanted us to say it word for word, right? Probably wanted us to cover those same topics, those same themes. But one of the things that I think sticks out, I know for me, and hearing the Lord's Prayer when we say it, is that "forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors," right? And it's not just a call that says, "Lord, forgive us," but it's a condition, right? It's a condition. "Lord, forgive us as we also forgive other people." And it's not a cry for help on both accounts. You're not asking God to forgive me and, "Lord, help me to forgive other people." You're saying, "Lord, forgive me in the same way I forgive other people." And that's very different. So it makes me ask, well, how do I forgive other people? Do I forgive other people, right? How easy is it for me to forgive? Because there is nothing more precious than forgiveness. To hear from another person, or to hear those words, or even to have someone come up to you and say, "I am sorry, I was in the wrong, please forgive me." And to have somebody say, "You know what, you know, I was wrong too, and of course this is in the past, I forgive you." Jesus told his disciples, ask for forgiveness. Ask for God's forgiveness every single time you pray. We always need God's forgiveness. There's no day that goes by that's perfect, right? I am not perfect any day. I am not sinless any day. So amidst the stream of things that I ask God for, one of those things I should be doing is constantly asking for forgiveness. And then remembering that part of the Lord's Prayer, that, "Lord, not only am I asking for forgiveness, but I'm remembering that I too need to forgive those who have wronged me." Right? I need to forgive. And if God is willing to forgive me, then I should be willing to forgive. And if Jesus teaches about, you know, the Good Samaritan and forgiving our enemy, and God is willing to forgive the most horrific enemy, then I should do nothing less, right? There's nothing anyone should do that should be outside my realm of forgiveness. Now, it doesn't mean that we forget the things that are done to us, especially things that were done on purpose, things that were done in spite. No one says you have to forget. No one says you have to allow toxic people back into your life. The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible doesn't say that you have to hang around people that are unhealthy for you. But we don't have a biblical excuse for having an unforgiving heart. We are still called to be people who forgive. And so I would say, first, you know, ask God to make you aware. Make you aware of those dark corners of your life, those things that need to be exposed to God's bright light. You know, God is light, God is truth, and he wants to shine his truth into those areas of our life that maybe we're even too scared to go. And say, "God, these are things that have been hidden." And I think now with the lockdown and some of us being on edge, some of those hidden things are coming out more because our stress levels are all high. So you say, God, you know, show me those places. And then pray, God, show me those people. Show me those people in my life that I have refused to let go of, that I'm still harboring grievances for, that I still have not forgiven. Lord, I want to have a forgiving heart. Show me those people that need my forgiveness. And I think both of those things would be very strong, very powerful prayers that I know God would love to answer for you. So this week, be aware of just our need to ask for God's forgiveness and our ability, this great ability that God has given us, that we have the power to forgive others that have wronged us and to release their burden and their stress. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for hanging out with us. Keep coming back. Every Monday, we'll have a devotional here for you. And remember, we go live Thursdays at 1 o'clock on Facebook Live, and we'll be back to church Sunday morning at 10. Peace be with you guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.